begin with a self-taught cook who took his past struggles along with his love of Texas and turned them into a pop-up serving Southern-style barbecue. Danielle Nottingham is right outside Long Beach with the pit master who customers call the Cambodian Cowboy. Danny, please explain the nickname.
Yeah, Jess, you gotta love that nickname. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Jess. And I'm going to let Chef Chad explain. The one thing I will say, he was born in Cambodia, so that starts it off. But how did you become the Cambodian Cowboy?
I became the Cambodian Cowboy during COVID when I made my barbecue business. I opened it up. I was by myself, and a lot of people came by in the patron. That's when they anointed me as the Cambodian Cowboy. And since on, you know, during COVID till now, everybody knows me as the Cambodian Cowboy now.
Well, they have to. Look at your hat. You got it. You got to do it. So let's go to the very beginning. You were born in Cambodia. What happened there that led you guys, you and your family, to come to America?
Well, we came to America because of there was a war, a genocide war, and we walked from Cambodia to the Thailand border for refuge.
Wow. And how old were you then?
I was about 7 years old.
And that's the name of the barbecue place, right? The province from Cambodia, Battambang.
Yes, absolutely. Battambang is the province, is an agricultural state in Cambodia. That's why, you know, Texas is almost like that, the Midwest. That's why Battambang barbecue and Texas barbecue, it's you know, it's a great mix.
A great mix. A nod to your grandparents, right?
Yes. My grandfather, he was actually a rice farmer. So, you know, he had two water buffaloes and an ox, you know, very primitive.
All right. Okay, so when you got to America, you ended up in Texas.
Yes.
So that's where you formed your love of barbecue. What were you doing in Texas?
So I left after high school to Texas back in the mid-90s. So I worked at a slaughterhouse. So I learned different parts of the operation and the meat packaging industry, from the gut table to the ground beef table to the brisket table. So that's why, I love trimming, I love barbecue.
All right, and we take one more detour, guys, because before you actually got into this, you were working at a surgery center. What happened there?
Yes, I was working at a surgery center for 17, 18 years in, you know, parts of Irvine and Long Beach. And, you know, like most people, during COVID, we couldn't go to our jobs. Or for me, like, you know, some people, we lost our jobs during COVID.
Right, and then that's where, you guys, take a look at this. This is where he got this smoker here. And you started doing this in your backyard?
Yes, I started smoking barbecue in my backyard, and that's when I went to ask my friend who has a noodle shop in North Long Beach if I could post in front of their noodle shop and start selling my barbecue.
All right, well, today we're in the parking lot of the 10 Mile Brewing Company.
Yes.
That's where you can find Chef. So before we go, though, we've got to talk about the flavors in your barbecue.
Yes.
How is this influenced by Cambodia? Take us through some of these dishes.
Oh, this is one of our bestseller side dishes. It's Cambodian coconut corn. It's butterless. It has coconut milk, a little sea salt, some chai. It's phenomenal. Very light, very organic, very refreshing. And over here, instead of a traditional American pickles, we have our green papaya slaw, which is organic, grown here locally, and with carrot, and it goes really well. You get that sweet savory that goes with the seasoned barbecue meat.
Okay, and of course, meat, right? That's all I see in front of me, Chef. What are your briskets? Take us through some of this.
Yeah, we have our smoke, 17-hour smoked brisket, our chicken, and our tri-tip. And over here, we have a specialty item. This is lemongrass smoked chicken, phenomenal flavors. A lot of lemongrass, known also as kruang. So kruang consists of lemongrass, galanga, garlic. It's the base of a Cambodian food. And then we have our short ribs and our sliders.
All right, I'm going to try the lemongrass because you said this was a very unique flavor. And while I'm trying this, please explain to everyone the little windmills. This is actually a really good tip if you're doing a picnic or a barbecue.
Yeah, there's a little windmill, you know, during the storm and stuff. And, you know, there's a lot of insect because of recent rain. So these keep the flies away, the insect. So if you're in your backyard, you could pick up one of these. It'll keep all the little mosquitoes and little flies away from your barbecue.
Oh, Chef, such a unique flavor. Thank you so much, everyone. Jess, if you want to come visit him, today he's in Long Beach, outside of Long Beach, at 10 Mile Brewing Company.
Yes.
Thank you so much. This is delicious. I think lunch is served for everyone, Jess.
I was going to say, we need some leftovers, Danny, so please bring whatever you have. And those little fly contraption things, they're the best. We actually have them in our backyard, and they work wonders. So thank you so much.